down. We don't need to frighten these people. Still a lot of rebels fighting back around here.
Itakwa was spared a lot of the early fighting.
The Plaga's going after them. Hard.
The rebels are pretty well dug in, though. We ought to be able to tip the scales a little for them. Like rebels. Wonder what they're up to. There's a cartel medal over here. It's gonna break some poor thug's heart to lose this. This is a commendation. Looks like it came from a box of cereal or the Air Force or something.
Sicario with a minigun, near the sandbag emplacement. We got a mounted weapon. We got a mounted weapon. Second target, right there. Eyes on a third. That's five tangos. Thank you. Eyes on a cartel heavy machine gunner near the airstrip.
I'm looking at a small group of tangos.
That's one less bad guy. Dad bird on patrol. Watch out.
Looney Dad headed this way. These supplies will buy us a lot of goodwill from the rebels.
I got it. I'll fly. she'd set up her own charity.
Quite the philanthropist.
Right. Money laundering?
Worse. A kind of student exchange program. She takes Bolivian teens and sends them north to the U.S., east to Europe.
I'm guessing they never make it to the Eiffel Tower.
Drug mules. What happens if they refuse?
Santa Blanca probably holds their families hostage here. Any of the teenagers ever get away?
As far as I could tell, only one. But as soon as he did, Nidia Flores sent his parents and two sisters to El Pozolero.
Pozolero? The stew maker. He puts people in 200-liter drums with water and sodium hydroxide. After 8 hours, there's nothing left but teeth, nails, and stew. Usually they're already dead before they go in the drum.
This time they weren't.
Fucking monsters.